Hey everybody, welcome to the channel. I'm Fox, and today I wanted to bring you my brand new Strikers Foul Spotter build. This is a variant of my traditional 6 red Foul Spotter build, which is my hardest hitting build today, and I absolutely adore using this in the Dark Zone and in Conflict. I usually run this build if I've got a healer or somebody running perfectly efficient survivalist, as you can keep yourself alive. But what I wanted to do with this particular variant was to see if running 3-piece Strikers, which usually equates to a large DPS hit, can actually make up for the fact that, you know, you do sort of tank a little bit of your damage. And the reason that you tend to is gear pieces only ever give you one instead of two minor attributes, and we're losing foxes and contractors. Now, I did a lot of damage testing with this build. What I did was essentially calculate the damage of crits and non-crits at a 60% ratio in a 41 bullet mag, to see, you know, and of course with the increased rate of fire with strikers, to see if it's going to be comparable. And it actually only does 6% less total DPS per mag compared to a non-strikers variant. So my other version of this is coyotes or walkers for my mask, contractors and foxes. So it's not actually that much less damage, but you know, it is still less damage. You may be thinking, well, what's the point? Just run your other 6 red build if it does more. And that is a good point, and I do still run that quite a lot. However, strikers offers us some fantastic benefits that really, really complement a low rate of fire, highly accurate weapon like the Foul. And whilst I wouldn't run strikers with high rate of fire weapons because I don't want to be reloading too much, it really, really enhances the strength of this weapons and almost completely nullifies its weakness. And that 6% DPS loss is more than made up for with the faster reloads and improved accuracy. Not only that, what I think a lot of people forget to factor in, and I've done this before as well, is people tend to calculate DPS over an entire mag, which is the right way to calculate it. But you've got to consider how long it takes to empty a mag on a particular weapon. The Foul takes a long time. You spend about 3 to 4 seconds firing before it empties the mag. So if somebody's only in your line of sight for, say, 1 second, then usually a higher rate of fire weapon is better if they're playing their corners well. And just achieving the same or very similar sort of damage, but doing it faster, means that if they're only visible for that 0.5 to 1 second, it's actually better. Strikers then ends up being better. So there's a lot of things you do have to calculate and consider when, you know, sort of working out rate of fire in strikers versus non-strikers and a few other things. But trust me, this build works really well, and I'm going to, in the usual fashion, go through the build and then load into a conflict game so I can show you how it all plays out. But I think I'm going to start running this over my usual 6 red. It just feels so good to use. And, you know, improving a weapon's handling and stability and so on at the slight DPS loss is usually better, because if you're hitting more shots because of that handling increase, well, then your DPS is naturally going to be higher anyway. So let's have a look at the build. I'll show you my stats afterwards, and then we'll load into that conflict game. We are running Technician for one reason and one reason alone, and that is because this is a Spotter build. I still think Spotter is the best talent in the game for the Foul. You know, Unbreakable is a very close second, and then you have talents like Obliterate and Glass Cannon, which also work incredibly well. But I think for me, Spotter is just too good, as it not only gives us a very good damage buff, but it also gives a lot of information to our teammates, which for me makes up for the lack of damage versus Obliterate and Glass Cannon. We do gain a +1 skill tier, which helps out the 2 skills that I'm using, which I'll come to shortly. So yeah, you know, Technician with Spotter is a must. What it also does is gives us the linked laser underbarrel, the pointer, which can only be equipped on long underbarrel rail weapons. So the FAMAS, for example, wouldn't work with this build. The Foul is my all-time favourite assault rifle. It's one of the highest DPS assault rifles in the game, be only outside of exotics, of course, by weapons like the Police M4 and the FAMAS, the high rate of fire ones. But the Foul hits hard, and its DPS is insane. The role that I've got here is basically perfect. I wouldn't change a single thing on this. You absolutely, like any PvP build, need to be running damage to targets out of cover. It works against anything in the game. It's super important to have this, and it is a multiplicative stat that pairs very nicely with InSync and with Spotter. InSync, again, is the best damage talent in the game, so what we really want to do is maximize the damage of this build. This is ultimately a 6 red build, so we need to be hitting hard and fast so that we don't have the risk of going down ourselves. This is going to give us a flat 30% weapon damage buff right from the very first bullet when propped with our drone or our shield. My secondary weapon is simply a military M870. What you use here is entirely your decision, just something that you can quickly close a kill down with if you run out of ammo. And then finally the Orbit, because again, this should always be used on any DPS build. Whilst you very rarely, and I very rarely, use my sidearm, if you do need to use it, this is the best one. It hits hard and it gives us the perfect finisher talent. This is a DZ exclusive, of course. So let's have a look at the gear side of things. We're running the Corsa 3-piece strikers to gain the 15% weapon handling and the 15% rate of fire. So that means that our weapon simply fires 15% more quickly, but what it also does is gives us at a 1-for-1 ratio with weapon handling, so 15% of each of these 4 stats, swap speed, reload speed, which is the most important out of the four, stability and accuracy. Now, luckily, the foul already has very high stability and accuracy. This thing is a laser, and if you haven't used it yet, you really, really need to try it. It is an absolute headshot magnet, and it just doesn't miss. And it also has incredibly good range drop-off as well, if you have a look at that damage drop-off graph just there. So the 15% handling just gives a lot of fantastic buffs, but the one that I like the most is that handling. And then, of course, the rate of fire just means that we're achieving similar damage, but in a shorter period of time, so we can just melt people down that aren't expecting us to be there. What you want to do, as is the case with all builds, is spec your weapon mods into crit chance as much as possible. So you see I've got the C79 scope, which is the best assault rifle scope in the game because it's 5% crit chance and it gives us the option to zoom in. The link laser pointer for obvious reasons, and then the crit chance muzzle just here. Everything else you spec into your build for crit chance. So you see my mask is crit chance, my gloves are crit chance, and because I had enough by this point, my knees are crit damage. To make sure that my damage was high enough, I tested this a few different ways. So I tested it with contractors, with foxes. Obviously, you can't have both unless you're going to lose a backpack or chest talent. But yeah, I tested it with both of those, and this was the highest damage combination versus a non-striker version. So, for example, you could have one-piece strikers as your holster and foxes, but this just equated to more damage. So what we've gone for is a Seska chest piece because we need to get our crit chance to 60%. That's very important as we don't have the luxury of running coyotes here. This chest is incredibly well rolled and it comes with the spotter talent that we need. Everything else in your build needs to be crit chance and crit damage, as that is very important. What spotter essentially does is amplify the total weapon and skill damage by 15% to pulsed enemies, which of course we're achieving from the link laser underbarrel. That also means that our striker drone is buffed as well. My holster is a Grupo to further enhance my crit damage. So this once again is rolled to crit chance and crit damage. And finally, to gain just the base weapon damage increase, we're running a Fenris backpack for that additional 10%. So we've got the Fenris, Seska and Grupo for all the weapon damage, crit chance and crit damage. What I've decided to go for here is Vigilance. And the reason for this is that if you are in the open being fired into with a 6 red build, there's a good chance you're going to go down. So you need to play it in a way that you're behind your team, flanking or on a corner. And with that case, you shouldn't be getting fired at as much, which means you're more likely to have Vigilance active. If you can get those first few shots off, Vigilance is fantastic. And it is further buffed and enhanced by strikers as we're firing more bullets in a quicker window, which equates to more bullets being buffed by Vigilance. And this is another DPS increase that you can't accurately measure. But ultimately, if I could fire 3 bullets before Vigilance wears away because I've been shot, or more like 5 bullets, then obviously the 5 bullets is better because it's more damage that is buffed and it's a 25% damage buff. So Vigilance, when paired with strikers, is actually a really nice DPS increase that I don't think is considered too much. The two skills that I'm using are the Crusader Shield, purely for an in-sync proc. This thing is not going to last very long at all. I'm just going to use it there to keep my Vigilance active. As don't forget, if they only damage your shield and not your personal armor, you don't lose Vigilance. And of course, to proc the 30% in-sync damage on my foul. And then finally, I do like to use a Striker Drone with this build, even in the DZ, because it actively shows me where enemies are that I might not always see myself. The damage is enhanced by Technician with the 10% skill damage, the +1 skill tier, and by Spotter as well. And this is just a constant in-sync proc. So if my shield breaks, what I'll usually do is set my drone, not so much on a player, but I tend to put it on somebody that is downed to guarantee that I get the kill and keep reprocking in-sync, or I'll put it on an enemy skill like a decoy, just because then your opposition are less likely to shoot it out if it's not targeting them, and you can just keep that in-sync active all of the time, as each fresh bullet fired that hits reprocs that 5-second window for in-sync. So that's the build there. Screenshot that if you would like to. What I'll now do is show you my stats. So weapon damage on this particular build is 54.5k PvP damage without any buffs applied. We're at exactly 60% chance. I was able to hit it dead on here, so not 0.1% over. And our crit damage is still very impressive at 142. Now, yes, you can get this way higher without strikers, probably like 30% higher, in fact, with coyotes. But trust me, this build still hits really hard and the DPS is very, very impressive. We don't have any damage to armor on this build. We do have the damage to health, which works against deployed skills such as stingers, which are everywhere at the moment, and mortar turrets, artillery turrets. And then what we're getting is all of these buffs here. So you see these are 25%. Now, by default, these are usually 10%, but these have all gone up because of the striker's benefit that we're getting on the build. Our armor stats are just base, so with my watch maxed out, we're at exactly 726k, no armor on killer armor regen, and 337 max health. So just all the usual stats on this section based on a high-level watch. So what we'll now do is load into a conflict game, and I'm going to show you just how hard this build melts. Okay, so we have loaded into a game with a missing player, which is awesome.
Rogue striker drone detected.
So you see what I'm talking about there. I know he was red shielded, which obviously isn't the best, best example, but... Oh, this guy's just running in like that. That's crazy. That's crazy. So all I'll do here is just redeploy my shield every time to make sure InSync is fully active. I've got my drone above my head, which will give me the little, in my case, right bumper highlight over somebody just in case I don't see them, or whatever it's assigned to on PC and PlayStation, of course. And I just find it's a very effective way to spot people before you can spot them. If that makes sense. Oh, the damage! The damage! Look at that, and the fast reload as well. Woo-wee! So much damage. Oh, I love it. I'm obsessed with this build. Nice dodge roll. Don't know why I zoomed in there, but... Oh, awesome damage. It's just ridiculous. Well, this has got to be the weakest heal I've ever seen.
The enemy has acquired a boost.
You may want to consider changing your skill there, good sir.
The enemy has acquired the boost.
Right, this is going to be a brave flank, so I think they're possibly going to see me coming in from this side, but... Oh, hello. Oh, he's got a shield out there. It's ridiculous. It's actually ridiculous. I didn't actually show it in my stats, but my Fal has been buffed to 740 RPM over the usual 650, so pretty high.
To be pulled out. You're too strong for them.
Shooting his feet underneath, and again, you can do things like that because of the natural stability of the Fal in conjunction with the increased stability from strikers.
Explosive seeker mine detected.
Oh, very nearly killed him. Oh, that drone might just finish him off. It didn't. Oh, that is a lot of damage. I haven't died yet, and I'm planning on keeping it that way.
Immediate medical assistance needed. Agent down.
Oh, we did just lose a guy to the right.
A specialization supply drop has been arranged for you.
Let's see if we can get a dirty little flank here. So much damage. How did I win that fight? How did I win that fight? Crazy. Crazy damage. So there it is. Apologies if I got a little bit carried away there, but you can just see how much that build rips through people. I know strikers is generally hated on because a lot of people will argue so, and rightly so actually. This, you know, it is a valid argument. That by running 3-piece strikers, you're losing out on all your damage to armor, damage to targets that are covered from foxes, and the two minor attributes as opposed to the one that you get with the gear set. But, you know, I spent a lot of time DPS testing versus other players and in the firing range. And, you know, like I said at the start, it's only a 6% DPS loss, but that is more than made up for the fact that you just reload so much faster. Your weapon is an absolute laser because of the handling. And if somebody is only visible for that half a second, for example, you just get more damage down in that window. Even if your per bullet damage is lower, the DPS is higher in that tiny window. Let's have a look at the stats. We're able to finish on 8 kills with 0 deaths and 3 assists, 40 million damage, mostly because I was just ripping through shields, which again is really good for. It looks like we had a pretty good game there. I think the enemy team got a little bit sort of caught back by it, so we did have a bit of an advantage right from the start, but Yeah, you know, I've really been enjoying this. I've been hitting this in the dark zone today with a couple of my friends from On The Move, OTM, and just destroying people. So let me know what you think in the comments, how you'd run your strikers build, or do you think I've really, you know, not done a good job with this particular version? Would you rather it was just the usual six red that we typically see with foxes and contractors? Please let me know. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Peace.